In this video, we will do an example involving Kruskal's algorithm. So remember the purpose of Kruskal's algorithm. We are given a connected graph, in fact, a connected weighted graph, and we want to find the spanning tree of least total weight. And that's exactly what Kruskal's algorithm does for us. Not only does it give us the correct answer, it is also an efficient algorithm, which means it does not take that long to execute. And so if we're looking at this example, we have a connected graph. In fact, this is a complete graph on 6 vertices, and the table below describes all the weights of every given edge. So before we apply Kruskal's algorithm, let's quickly recall how many spanning trees that this graph possesses. Now, in general, there's no easy way to determine the number of spanning tree a graph has. However, in this case, this is a complete graph, and so there is an easy formula to calculate the number of spanning trees. If you have a complete graph with n vertices, then the number of spanning trees is n raised to the n minus 2. In this case, we have 6 vertices, and so the number of spanning trees is 6 to the 6 minus 2, so this is 6 to the 4, and if we calculate this out, this is 1,296. So already we can see that taking the brute force approach would be a very bad idea in this case. We'd have to list out all possible 1,296 spanning trees, calculate the weights. It would be a long process. A computer could make it shorter, but we'll see that Kruskal's algorithm is an even easier way to find the answer that we're looking for. So recall that the very first step involves taking all the possible weights and listing them from smallest to largest. So if you look at the possible weights in our table, you should see that the smallest weight is 41. After that, so we can kind of put a mark next to them to indicate we've used that one. So after that is 50, then 72, then 81, then 83, then 84, then 102, then 113, then 120, then 122, and 140, 146, 147, 150, and finally 151. So here we've used all the 15 weights. So now the next step is we choose the cheapest edge, 41, and we draw it in on our graph. So notice that 41 corresponded to the edge AF, and so that's what we color in. And now 50 we can use, so 50 corresponded to the edge AC. So now remember, our only criteria when we're choosing an edge is that it does not make a circuit. So we just keep going to the next cheapest edge that we have not used and just choose it as long as it doesn't make a circuit. Otherwise, we put an X next to it and simply move on. So what about 72? Well, 72 would correspond to edge CF in our table, and so you can see that choosing CF would give us a circuit. It would give us a circuit CFAC. So we cannot choose that. What about 81? Well, 81 corresponds to the edge DE, and we can use that. Edge 83. So that would correspond to the edge CD, and that also is fine. That works. 84. 84 would correspond to the edge EF. Now notice that if we drew in the edge EF, we would have a circuit, right? We would have circuit EDCAFE. So we're not allowed to use that one. 102, we look in our table, and that corresponds to the edge AE. Again, you can see that drawing in the edge AE would give us a circuit, EDCAE. So we can't use that. 113 is the edge DF. And again, we can see that using DF would give us a circuit. We cannot use that. 120. 120 corresponds to the edge DA. DA would also give us a circuit. So we can't choose that. Now at 122, that corresponds to the edge CE, and CE would give us a circuit, so we don't want that. Now with 140, we'd have the edge BC, And now we can see that that would not give us a circuit, so we can choose that edge. Now, if we look at our picture, we've noticed that we have what we want, right? We had 6 vertices, and we've just chosen 5 edges. So remember the property that if you have a tree with n vertices, it has n minus 1 edges. So here we've chosen 5 edges, so that's it. We have our spanning tree. And so we don't have to worry about choosing into the investigating in the other edges we haven't used yet. We don't proceed. We're not going to use them. We have the spanning tree of least total weight. So this is a rather remarkable algorithm, because out of all the possible 1,296 spanning trees, we have found the best answer, the spanning tree of least total weight, and it was very easy.